In this video, we will be discussing how to find a hypothesis test for proportion using the hypothesis testing tool. So let's get started. In the hypothesis testing tool, we have three different tabs down here: z-test, t-test, and prop test. The prop test is the only test that will be involving proportions. So if you know that your problem is involving proportions or percentages in testing a claim, then we know that we're dealing with testing a proportion or finding a hypothesis test involving proportion. And prop test would be the right tool. Notice in this problem that we have test the claim that the proportion of people who own cats is smaller than 40%. So notice that it says that we're dealing with proportion. We're dealing with proportion of people. So in this case, we want to use the prop test. And the first thing that we're dealing with in this problem is the null and alternative hypothesis. The null hypothesis is H naught, H sub zero, and alternative hypothesis is H sub one. And that's the first part that we're dealing with here. We need to fill in the blanks. And I've already filled this in, but notice that we have a test and the claim, we're testing the claim of the proportion, and we want to know if the proportion who own cats is smaller than 40%. So the 40% is part of the claim, and that's what goes right here. In decimal form, we're going to put 0.4 here and 0.4 here. The same value always goes here and here. Notice that. Now, we need to fill in cell C5 and C6, and we will have to look at the wording of the problem, the wording of the claim. So we want to test the claim that the proportion of people who own cats is smaller or less than. So that tells us our alternative hypothesis inequality is less than. And then we notice that the null hypothesis inequality up here in cell C5 is always the opposite. So this will be greater than or equal to. And there's no actual way to type this in just with your keyboard. So you can just do greater than or equal to. It's not really that big a deal because, or greater than or equal to, it doesn't really matter. But notice that eventually we're going to be dealing with cell C6 later. So what's really important is what you're putting in cell C6. And from this, we can answer the first part of this question. Notice that if we're dealing with proportion, that the null and alternative hypothesis will involve P. That's already given to you. So we could have eliminated the second, the fourth, and the sixth option, which involves mu. That's the Greek letter mu, which represents population mean. We're not dealing with mean. That is what you'll find over at Z and T. Notice that we have mu here and here, but not here. We're dealing with proportion, so population proportion goes here, not population mean. So it's either option 1, 3, or 5, and you'll see that it would be option 1, as we can see here. Based on the claim again, the inequality is based off of the claim is smaller. So that's what we have in the alternative hypothesis, less than. Okay, now we also in this first sentence have the level of significance. 0.005, we can put that in here. Now in this tool that we're dealing with here, the 0.005, this level of significance, isn't actually used to calculate anything down here, but we're just going to use it as a comparison later, as you'll see. Okay, now we need the number of successes and the sample size. Those are the last two things we need to enter, and that's given to us down here. Based on a sample of 300 people, sample size, a sample of 300 sample size, the number of successes, now we need the number of successes, which is X. Sample size is N, number of successes is X. But we have 35% owned cats. So we can actually use a formula here. We can type in a formula and say, okay, this is equal to 35% of our sample size multiplied by the cell down here. And that will give us the number of successes. So we weren't actually directly given the number of successes, but we can calculate that by multiplying the percentage, in decimal form of course, by the sample size. And that will tell us what how many is 35% of our sample size. And from that, as you can see, we did it correctly, because the sample proportion is 35%, 0.35 in decimal form, and we have all the necessary information. Now we just need to interpret this. Okay, so we have a p-value. We want to know the p-value. Well, actually, we also want to know what type of test, the left tail, right tail, or two tail. Well, that's actually determined on rows 17, 18, and 19. We need to figure out which one we're dealing with. To do this, we need to look at cell C6. As mentioned right here, cell C6. Notice that based on the claim, we determined it's less than. So we're looking actually at not row 17 or 19, but row 18, which has the less than here. So this is a left tail test. So we know the answer is left tail because they're dealing with less than. And this is the p-value. The p-value is 0.38 or 0.0385. And make sure you round to the correct amount of decimals as mentioned. So two decimals in this case, so that would be 0.04. And now we want to make a decision. Based on this, we either reject the null hypothesis or we fail to reject the null hypothesis. And here's the decision that we need to make. And you need to make the decision based on this rule. If the p-value is less than alpha, this is where the comparison comes in. Alpha is the level of significance. Alpha equals, in this case, 0.005. Remember, our p-value is right here in the middle, in row 18. So is the p-value less than or greater than alpha? Notice it's 0.04 versus 0.005. So alpha is smaller. It's a whole different decimal over. So 0.04 and 0.005, so 0.04, the p-value, is larger than alpha. So in this case, we fail to reject the null hypothesis, H0. We fail to reject the null hypothesis. Okay, so that is how you use the hypothesis testing for proportion tool, the prop test, in the hypothesis testing tool in Google Sheets.